ClickUp has launched 4.0 with some new functionality that includes four major changes. The first major change is how you navigate ClickUp, that is global navigation. Second is planner. Third, brain. And fourth is the Teams hub. In this video, I will go through these four improved features side by side in comparison with ClickUp 3.0 so that you can understand the key differences. Hi, I'm Hina, founder of IT Visionist and a systems consultant. I have been using ClickUp since 2017, but jumped into the partnership in 2023. After testing and using 20 plus project management tools, I have settled with ClickUp. Excited about the new developments. Let's get started. Workspaces that were previously on 3.0, admins and owners can try ClickUp 4.0 for themselves or their entire workspace. So if you go to your workspace name, click on the settings, and you will see ClickUp 4.0 available here. If you want to use it by everyone, you should choose everyone to try using 4.0. Or if you just want to try it for yourself first, then you should enable this. New workspaces automatically have 4.0. In ClickUp 3.0, this is what you see when you log in into your ClickUp workspace. You have a Home tab here, Inbox, Chat, Teams, what you have pinned up in this menu. It all shows up here on the sidebar, and then you have your favorites tab here. Spaces appear here, and if you scroll down, this is all how it looks, and you can invite your team members or go to help. However, if you now go into ClickUp 4, global navigation, which is a vertical bar on the left side of your workspace. It remains open from anywhere in ClickUp, and you can pin or unpin global navigation features from the menu here. Here you can see spaces, chat, whiteboards, etc. You can access your notifications, tasks, conversations, and favorite items from the converged, customizable home sidebar here. The default home sidebar items include inbox, replies, assigned comments, my tasks, and then from the more tab, you can come in and pin chat activity, drafts, send posts, all channels, all spaces, or all tasks as well. What's good here is that you can create your own layout using the personalized sidebar. Choose which items stay visible in your home sidebar from the customization menu. These changes will not affect the rest of the team, so now you can organize your work your way. You can customize the global navigation here as well. What items you want to see and what you don't want to see. Check or uncheck them. You can see here that I have spaces shown up here, the favorite section, channels, direct messages, and if you have any customized sidebar that would start appearing here as well. What's new is that you can also have personalize your sidebar. So if you come here and click on personalize your sidebar, you can name it. This will create the custom view for you. Here you can add your sections from anywhere in the workspace. With this cleaned up navigation, you can group together similar work. Anything for a specific project, a channel, a list, a dashboard, all grouped together for an easy access. You can apply quick filters to jump to your unread messages or your DMs. My Tasks has a whole new view in ClickUp 4.0. If you go back to ClickUp 3.0, this is how everything looks like, where you can have your tasks, your agenda items, your work assigned to you, assigned comments, priorities, and all that you can manage through the cards. And then the inbox had a different tab. ClickUp 4.0 gives you a more organized way to manage your tasks and see what's in your plate. My Task is a personalized canvas with all your assigned work. You have now a distinction to see what's assigned to me today and overdue, and a personal list, which is a full page on its own, which was actually just a card in 3.0. This 4.0 navigation seems quite simpler and cleaner to me. In ClickUp 3.0, there is no way where you can just have spaces shown up. You have to navigate all through these sections that will stay visible all the time. However, in ClickUp 4.0, with global navigation, if you just click on spaces, it will show you the spaces and rest is hidden. Please note that guests are limited members, and limited members view only can only see locations and items shared with them, so they may not be able to see the full spaces sidebar here. You can access your most recent direct messages and channel conversations using chat. To use the chat sidebar, an admin or owner must activate the chat click app in your workspace. The chat sidebar can be accessed from your global navigation as well. In ClickUp 3.0, you were not able to access Brain as a whole page. It appeared like this. You search for it and it popped up. In ClickUp 4.0, if you go into the global navigation, Brain has its own new page. Plus, there is an easy access now. Just click space anywhere in ClickUp to open a new AI command bar. ClickUp 4.0 Planner has some upgrades. It supports multiple time zones, combined availability for meetings, and AI note taker. So just need to come in here and choose who you want to meet with, search for the people, and it will show you their availability. You can drag and drop the schedules here as well. If you're going to the plus icon on the planner here, it will give you an option to create an event or to set up your focus time, where you can actually block time for a perfectly planned day. It also takes care of out of office or non-working days. Once you had set up your out-of-office hours, the planner will take care of them in planning events. You can now also link your events with your tasks or your docs. When you have upcoming meetings, it shows up on the top. When the meeting starts, you will have a notification popping up here, and it will show you that in your events, you can also set up where the meeting should take place. You can add video call options from Google Meet, Zoom, or sync up calls. ClickUp Sync now allows you to have video calls as well in ClickUp 4.0. Teams in ClickUp 3.0 appear like this, where you have the teams, you can also see all people, and then you were able to see the analytics for them, how active they are and how they are working. ClickUp 4.0 brings a new interface to Teams, which looks really great. Everything about your team's priorities to performance. It brings together analytics, priorities, feed, team, AI-powered stand-up updates, and your timesheets. Every team has a feed where you can actually share updates from a team. And if you click on a profile, it will show you the individual activity of that particular person. So you can have individual and team profiles to know about who someone is and what role they have in the team. From just one click, you can actually see what they are working on. This helps you see what each individual is doing, who their manager is. You can set up the title, and whether they are online or not, then you can chat with them directly as well. In ClickUp 3.0, if you're using chat, you have to communicate with a human, right? And have to wait for the answer. Send a message here and wait for reply. In the agents, there is autopilot agent, but still in beta. However, with ClickUp 4.0, if you have this agent enabled, autopilot agent that says answers, it answers the questions posted in the chat using the information in your workspace. So if you'll ask the question, the autopilot works for you and it generates you an answer. Because this question is related to the particular channel that I'm asked, you can see the reply here. I had asked how many tasks are overdue, and it shows me 3 tasks and link to them as well. Tasks have some changes to the layout as well. Custom fields, subtasks, create checklists, attach files, these are all now collapsible. Relationship items or add dependencies are now under the task description and in the right sidebar. Quick links are above the task title. Now you can schedule comments, replies, and emails from tasks to be sent at a later date and time. When you schedule them, they will be shown under Drafts and Sent. You have 3 tabs here. Drafts, Scheduled, and Sent. You can also navigate to them under the Home, Drafts, and Sent. In ClickUp 3.0, reminders were sent to Home, but here when you set up reminders, they can be sent to your inbox. You can continue to create and view legacy reminders from the reminders or my work card in my tasks. Snooze in your inbox is termed as later in ClickUp 4 now, and it shows you all the reminders and schedules that you have. Location headers can be added to your favorites, a custom section in your home sidebar, or pinned it to the top of your workspace. And if you pin it to the home sidebar, it will show up in the left panel under your favorites. In ClickUp 3.0, items could be created from the new button. Now it's called Create, and it's on the right side of the toolbar. The quick action menu is now named as Personal Tools, where you can pin or unpin whatever you want to see on the top right corner. Moving towards the docs, the right sidebar icons now align with the new task redesign. Here you can set up the entire doc or this page. The comments icon is now in the right sidebar. If you go into the view changes, they can now be saved by clicking a button instead of a pop-up that was in 3.0. So if I make a change here, you'll see that there is a save view button that appears on the top now, which I can use to save the view or reward the changes. In addition to these changes, there is improvement in the load time, especially in the Gantt charts. Earlier, they used to take ages, but now you can see that they load quite easily here. So in channels, you can also bookmark tasks or notes, calculations, task list, and battery chart. You can add a bookmark here. I want to add this list here, so I will add it to my bookmarks and it will start appearing. You can add another one. Let's have notes, and then you can add it in your notes as well. That's all about the key differences and improvements that ClickUp 4 is bringing to you. Excited to try the new interface? I would suggest to enable it for yourself first and then launch it for the whole team. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. If you have any questions, feel free to comment and I'll try my best to answer all comments there. Thank you for watching.